class, so I were able to see it. All right, so yesterday we talked about Katherine Johnson. And if you haven't seen that movie, it's on Disney Plus, so you can watch it at home. It's called Hidden Figures. And it's about a lady who is very smart in math, but she helps the astronauts get back home from a disaster that happened, an explosion happened during space. So she had to use her math skills to help navigate the spaceship back to Earth. And so it's a true story. And it's a really amazing story. And we got to learn about her yesterday. Her name is Katherine Johnson. Today, who we're going to be learning about is Frederick Douglass. And so in Seesaw, what you're going to be doing is you're going to activities. And then right here, it says, it's supposed to say 2-9. So February 9th, Black History Month, Frederick Douglass. So we are going to listen to a video with Frederick Douglass and who he is and how he's important to our community.
Quality writing.
So let me go ahead and stop sharing this and share the video. That way you're able to listen in on the video. So Miss Flington's going to mute herself. There is a commercial for about 4 seconds, so give it a chance to pass. Better.
Meet Grammarly.
All right, so Miss Flington's going to mute herself, and I'm going to make it bigger so that you can see a little bit better. Miss Owlschool has it on the big screen if you can't see it on your iPad screen, so that way you have an alternative to look at, okay?
All right, today we are going to learn about Frederick Douglass. But first, we would love to hear from you. 9-year-old Jeannie from Canada watched our sentence fragments video and said, I have my writing project due tomorrow, and this helped me a lot. Wow, that is awesome. 14-year-old Matthew from Jamaica watched our Great Wall of China video and said, this is so awesome, I may be a teenager, but I learned so much. Very cool. People of all ages can learn with our videos. And finally, Miss D'Antonio's class from New York asked, how do camels protect themselves? By camouflaging. That's awesome. Thank you. A huge thank you to the whole class. That was great. Well, that was pretty cool. Be sure and watch this video to the end to learn how you too, you could be featured on one of our videos. Well, as we mentioned earlier, today we are going to learn about Frederick Douglass. Frederick Douglass, you're going to learn all about him in this video. Frederick Douglass was a public speaker and a writer who fought for the rights of African Americans and women. He was one of the main leaders who helped end slavery, working together with President Abraham Lincoln. Let's learn about his life.
He's one of our presidents.
Frederick Douglass was born in 1818 in the state of Maryland. Do you know where Maryland is in the United States? Where is Maryland? Yeah, Maryland is right here. It's in the northeastern part of the United States. Back then, Maryland was a state that allowed slavery. Slavery is a terrible system in which people are treated like property instead of people. Frederick Douglass was born into slavery. Because he was born a slave, he wasn't treated with the kindness and the respect that he deserved as a person, because slaves were treated as property, which was why slavery was so wrong. He had to work in the fields regardless of how cold or miserable it was outside. Life was so difficult. He had to work in the morning, way into the evening, working hard every single day, and was not treated with any dignity or any respect at all.
I absolutely love teaching. I just wish I had more time to prepare fun lessons.
Because he was a slave, Frederick Douglass was not allowed to go to school or learn how to read. But he learned anyway. Isn't that incredible? He taught himself how to read. Frederick Douglass taught himself how to read because he knew it was so important. He knew that learning was important. He knew that learning could be an incredible step towards freedom. Then an incredible thing happened. When Frederick Douglass was 20 years old, he escaped from slavery. He fled to New York, a state that did not allow slavery. He was finally a free man. It wasn't until he was 20 years old that he became free. Frederick Douglass became a preacher and got a lot of experience in public speaking. He spoke against slavery. People who spoke against slavery were called abolitionists. That's a pretty long word, isn't it? Abolitionists. Frederick Douglass was one of the leading abolitionists, one of the leading people who fought against slavery. Frederick Douglass started writing books, and people were amazed at his books, not only because they were so well written, but because of the fact that Frederick Douglass was self-taught. He taught himself how to read and write. Frederick Douglass began speaking across different states, sharing a message of equality and freedom. It was sad. People often mistreated him, but he refused to quit. There were even times where people would throw eggs at him. They were so angry about his message, but Frederick Douglass knew that equality was important, and he knew that slavery had to end. Frederick Douglass became so famous in the abolitionist movement that he became an advisor to President Abraham Lincoln. Abraham Lincoln listened to Frederick Douglass. He respected his opinion and he listened to his message. He knew that what Frederick Douglass was saying was true. Finally, in 1863, Abraham Lincoln declared all slaves to be free through the Emancipation Proclamation. It was a presidential proclamation that said, "All slaves are now free." For the rest of his life, Frederick Douglass fought for equal rights. He fought for voting rights for African Americans. He fought for equal pay for African Americans in the military. And he fought for a woman's right to vote. He was passionate about everybody being treated with the respect that they deserved because he never forgot where he came from and he understood how important freedom really is. Frederick Douglass, a former slave who became a public speaker, a writer, someone who fought for the rights of African Americans and women. Thanks for watching this Homeschool Pop video on Frederick Douglass. We hope you learned a lot, and we hope you share some of these things with others, because Frederick Douglass was an incredible man who fought for the freedom of so many Americans.
All right, guys, so I'm going to go ahead and show you your assignment for Frederick Douglass. We learned a lot about him and how he's a very intelligent person, and he even taught himself to read, and that is very hard to do, but you can do it too, right? So if he can do it, you can do it. So you got to have determination. So right here is the assignment. So it says, watch the video about Frederick Douglass. So we just did that. Number two says, read and answer the comprehension questions about Frederick Douglass. The open-ended question will be graded. So make sure I will show you what the open-ended question says. So right here is a small reading activity that you're going to do. And so what the direction says, read the passage 3 times to practice fluency. So how many times are you going to read this?
Three
times. Because it's supposed to help you at least two times. You don't have to do three, but at least two times read this, because you'll sometimes your brain, when you read too fast, you forget information. So if you reread and reread again, you'll get those facts down. So here it says at the bottom, show what you know. So it says use a yellow crayon. So you'll need a yellow crayon or a yellow pencil. So you might want to get that out to highlight the reason that Frederick Douglass learned to read and write. Ooh, that's a good one. So the yellow one, that's what you need, a yellow crayon. Another crayon that you need is use a blue crayon. So this, so you'll do the highlighting tool in this case, since it's online and you have all your colors right here. So use a blue crayon or a color pencil to show the sentence that defines the word freedom. Ooh, so now you're going to use the blue highlighter to find what freedom means. Remember, it has a text feature in there that we learned yesterday about italics. Remember the leaning letters? So if you can find the leaning letter of freedom, you need to highlight that in blue to see what it means. Then it says use the green highlighter to highlight how Frederick Douglass escaped from slavery. So this is like a search and find. So you basically will read this together, and then you're going to search and find it with a partner. Okay. So right here at the very bottom is what Mrs. Fullington is going to be grading. The respond. So you see the two lines? You have two lines, so you have plenty of room to write your answer. So it says, how did Frederick Douglass help other people? Write one way on the line. So you are going to find an answer in this story of what one way Frederick Douglass helped people. You can even rewatch the video to find one way he helped people. Okay, because I can guarantee you there was more than one way in that video that Frederick Douglass helped people. So I'm going to go ahead and read this first. So it says, one of the most famous people in the anti-slavery movement was Frederick Douglass. In his lifetime, he was enslaved, then became a civil rights activist and a writer. So a civil rights activist is a person who is fighting for people's rights, equal rights. So remember, he was fighting to end slavery and for women's rights. So that's civil rights activists. Frederick Douglass was born on a plantation in Maryland. His mother was enslaved, so he was born into slavery. He grew up away from his mother, and he moved around to different slave owners. And he had a hard childhood. Children born into slavery were not allowed to go to school. They were not allowed to learn to read and write. One of Frederick's slave owners had a wife who started to teach him how to read. So it says in the video that he taught himself, but he had a little help. The slave owner found out, and he made her stop teaching him. He said that Frederick should not know how to read. That's not fair, is it? How would you feel if somebody told you that you should not read? It says Frederick Douglass loved to learn. He wanted to learn more, so he worked on ways to learn to read and write. So here's where he started to teach himself. He spent a lot of time studying and practicing, and soon he knew how to read and write, and he taught others too. As Frederick Douglass got older, he focused more and more on gaining freedom. Freedom is the power to do what you want to do. People who were enslaved had a very difficult life. They did not have rights. This meant the owners could treat them in terrible ways. He thought of ways to escape from slavery. Finally, he did it. He pretended to be a sailor and carried papers that showed that he was a free black person. And he escaped to New York City. This was very risky. So that means it was very dangerous. When Frederick Douglass lived in New York, his life was still not easy. He worked with other people to end slavery, and he told stories about when he was enslaved. He wrote stories about his experience. This made other people want to end slavery too. Frederick Douglass believed in equal rights. He believed that everyone should be free and talented, treated fairly. He worked hard to help make things better for people. So, with a partner, you need to find the yellow highlighter in your seesaw. In the yellow highlighter, you're going to find the reason that Frederick Douglass learned to read and write. So you need to find that answer in yellow. blue highlighter. You're going to show the sentence that defines the word freedom, and it's in there. I read it. I remember seeing it. And then three, you're going to use the green highlighter, how Frederick Douglass escaped slavery. So I should see three colors in this story. And then the respond is what Mrs. Fullington's going to grade you on. How did Frederick Douglass help other people? Write one way on the lines. So with a partner, you're going to search and find those three answers. Then you're going to write your answer on the lines. Do we understand? Does anybody have any questions? Marissa? You got it, Marissa? Aaliyah, if you're right by Marissa, can you help her press the microphone? Okay, Marissa, what was your question, sweetie? Thank you, Aaliyah.
My question was, can we work with teammates?
Yes, that's what partners means. It means you can work with a teammate.
Okay.
Thank you for answering that question. All right, Maddox, I saw your hand up, sweetie. What was your question?
What group are you meeting today?
I'm sorry, sweetie, I can't hear you.
What group are you meeting with today?
Well, it's going to be a little bit different. Miss Fullington will not be able to meet with any other groups until next week. Because of STAR testing for the upper grade levels, it shortened our reading time. So I won't be able to meet with any reading groups until next week because Friday we have early release and then I won't be able to do that because we got our party, okay? Thank you for asking that question. All right, if there's not any more questions, you may log out and I will see you at 9 o'clock for reading, okay? It's a little bit shorter, so make sure you take care of your business.
Miss Fullington.
Hi, guys. Yes, Isabella?
My mama's food stamps come in tomorrow.
Okay. Sounds good. All right. We'll see you at 9 o'clock, guys.